The jumper, all right.
Now, it was a very demanding role for you. Would you say it was your most demanding film?
I think it was my most dramatic, one of the most dramatic films that I've ever been in, really. Mm-hmm. You know, because, you know, usually they, when they see Scatman, they think happiness and all this giant, but this was a very, all drama, you know what I mean?
Quite a look of fear expressed through Jack Halloran.
Yeah.
But it was also demanding, not only in the role you played, but in the way the film was made. It took a long time to make the film.
Yes, I was over 8 months.
And take after take. Oh, I've heard rumors that Kubrick would do 50 takes was not unusual.
Well, certainly not, because one day with the entire cast, we did 87 takes on about a 2-minute scene. 87 takes.
Straight through.
Yep.
Wow.
In one scene where I was getting out of the snowcat, walking in the snow to the hotel, back door of the hotel, 40 takes, no dialogue. So I says to Stanley, after being working with him for about 8 months, what was wrong that time, Stanley? Was I walking in rhythm or was I walking out of rhythm? He says, no, Scat, says, you walked just a little bit too far left. I said, okay.
So when you're making a film, I mean, do you immerse yourself in that character? Or do you just feel it as Scatman would feel it?
Well, I'm going to be me and the character that I'm portraying, see? Yeah, sure.
It's the beauty of your performance is the naturalness of it. We don't feel like we're watching an actor.
No, well, I just be yourself, you know.
Well, you wrote a little bit of a song about Stanley Kubrick.
Oh, yes. One day I walked on the set, and I says to Stanley, I said, Stanley, says, would you mind if I wrote a tune about you? And he is somewhat a little shy. He says, no, Scott, I'd be delighted. I says, thank you, because I've already written it. And he kind of laughs. He says, yeah. Now, to show you how concerned he is, he says, what's the title of the tune that you've written for me? I said, well, the title of the tune is Stanley, and in parentheses, does it all. He says, could I hear a few bars of it? I said, sure. So I took him over to this table where Jack was doing all this typing. So I said, now here's where it goes. I said, I'll sing you a few bars of it. Doom, shoo beam da doom, shoo ding doom, shoo ding da doom. There's a man, doom ding doom, shoo beam da doom, shoo ding. Living in London town, shoo beam da doom, shoo beam da doom, shoo ding da doom. Makes movies. Shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam da doom. He's worried now. Shoo-beam da boom, shoo-beam da boom, shoo-beam da boom. Yes, he's really got the fame. Stanley Kubrick is his name. He does it all. Shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam da doom. He does it all. Shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam da doom. I'm telling y'all. Shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam. Stanley does it all. Shoo-beam da doom, shoo-beam da doom. He's a writer. He directs. He produces his projects. He's the man behind the lens. And Stanley always wins. He's a man who looks ahead, can make you think he raised the dead. Edison cuts all his flicks. He's a genius with his tricks. He does it all. Shoom ding doom, shoom ding doom, shoom ding doom. He does it all. Shoom ding doom. Man, he flipped.
No, I did too.
And his daughter Vivian, she was doing the documentary film.
Behind the scenes.
So she said, now, Scatman, when you finish your movie, says, now, when I interview you, you will have to do the tune that you have written for my father. So the tune is in the documentary film. If she ever releases it, she's bad as her father. I don't know when she's going to release it.
Well, I'm hoping that there are some major record company people around here to make a great release.
Oh, yes. And I had a line where it says, it was not a silver lining. Wait until you see the shining, a revelation to behold that will chill the young and old. He does it all. Doom, doom, doom. Yeah.
It's a great song.
Yeah, it's the truth. It's just the man. It's him. It's him. Man.
Now, you made your living doing music for a long time.
Yeah.
Tell me a little about the Scatman Crothers combo.
Well, now, I organized my band, Mick, back in 1936. I had a 5-piece band, and the first name that I called it was Scatman and His Cats. Ah. Then later on, I just called it Scatman Group, you know, a combo. Yeah, I had a piano, I was playing drums, and I played the drums. I had a pianist, and I had an alto player, and a bass, and a trumpet, five of us.
Yeah. Now, where'd you form?
Pardon?
Where'd you form the band?
In Paris, Illinois, 20 miles from where I was born, Terre Haute, Indiana.
Is that where you met your wife?
No, I met my wife in Canton, Ohio in 1936 when I was working with my band at the Commodore Hotel.
Uh-huh.
And she and her girlfriend was there at night, and I saw them dance, and they would walk up and ask for requests, and I would play them for them. Then I had to leave and go to Springfield, Illinois. And I said, boy, if I ever come back to Canton, I hope I run into her again. And as luck would have it, I ran into her again, man, at the same hotel, and that's when we got together. See, we've been together for 44 years.
That's congratulations
yes,
on that.
44 years. Wouldn't trade it for the world.
Now, a few days from our taping date here, you got a birthday coming up.
Yes, I have a birthday, May 23rd. Be 71.
71.
71.
I can't believe it.
Yes,
I cannot
71.
Believe it.
Well, yes.
Tell me a little bit about the changes from, you came to Hollywood in what,
1945. From Chicago.
Now, you're here in Hollywood working as much as ever, even more than ever, it seems to me.
Right.
Tell me the changes that have gone on. What strikes you most?
Well, there wasn't much violence in those days. Mm-hmm. Everybody was happy. You could walk the streets, leave your doors open at home, and everybody was happy, you know what I mean? Of course, they wasn't making a whole lot of money, but everybody was happy. It was just a lot of love, looked like, in those days, man. You know,
innocence,
I mean?
Maybe?
Yes, yes, yes. But it's changed considerably now because these actors and actresses, they haven't really actually paid any dues.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
And, you paid a healthy amount of dues,
yes,
didn't you?
Oh, yes, you got to pay. Yeah, I paid my dues, man. That's why I appreciate my success because I paid my dues. You know.
Well, you don't talk about it much, but your success has led to you being able to help out a lot of causes.
Right, right.
We see you on telethons all the time, taking part in charity organizations.
Sure,
something
sure.
that you should get a pat on the back for every
well,
now
I
and then.
Well, I enjoy doing things like that, you know.
What do you want to do most with your life?
What I want to do most with my life? Just be myself and treat people like I like to be treated and that's it, you know what I mean?
Well, you're doing it.
Yes, yes.
You get that back in spades, too, I bet.
Pardon?
You get that back in spades.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Now, let's talk a little about some of the favorite things that you've done. What have you enjoyed doing most? Has it been acting in films? Has it been playing music? Has it been your family?
Well, my family comes first. Then after my family, well, you know, music is really my thing, really. I love music, man. But I love all aspects of the entertainment business, but music is my first love, really, mm-hmm. I'll be honest with you. I enjoy making people happy by singing and doing a little comedy, you know.
Sure.
You know.
Now, what about your screen work, TV and film? You've done so much of it. Is there anything that stands out that you enjoy doing most?
Well, I just finished a little thing. You might have caught it the other night on NBC. I did a thing called The Globetrotters on Gilligan's Island. Now, I had a lot of fun working with those Globetrotters because they are such a great bunch of fellows, man. And I had a lot of fun doing that movie, two-hour movie.
Right. So the things that appeal to you most are the actual making of the film rather than the watching of it.
Right, right. Because I like Stan, I'm glad you mentioned that because Stanley Kubrick in England, when we shot our first scene, he says to the entire cast, he says, okay, now let's go watch it on videotape. I said, Stanley, is that compulsory? He says, no, Scott, why? I said, because I don't want to see it. I don't want to see it that the product is finished. I never like to see the rushes or watch it on videotape. When the product is finished, then I like to go see it.
Yeah. You go to your movies? Do you see your
movies? I go to the screenings, but I don't go to the theaters.
No? You don't go to movies much at all?
No, I don't go to movies.
It's doing them, not watching them that you like.
Doing them and not watching them is right. Yeah.
What do you got coming up?
Well, I don't, I got several
You're
gonna
take
projects.
It easy for a while?
I have several projects in the making. I don't know which one that my agent, Don Swartz, is going to select. I mean, we have a lot of things going, but I don't know what he's going to
Well, The Shining,
for me
The Shining was a real change for you. It was a scary film.
Yes, it was.
How'd that
my
feel?
First horror movie ever made.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How did that feel?
Well, it was nice. It was a new experience for me. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed working with the little kid, beautiful little kid.
Yeah.
You know, I enjoyed working.
It was a good part for you.
Yes, it was.
It was nice to change hats
every
now and then.
Yes.
But you're still the good guy. You're usually a good guy. That's a nice beam you've got coming out, right?
Yeah.
You like playing a villain now and then?
Well, let's see. I think, did you see King of Marvin Gardens?
I didn't see it.
Well,
I know your part.
I was a pretty bad dude in that movie.
You're a pimp, weren't you?
I was a gangster. I had all these guys working. I had Bruce Dern, all those guys working for me, you know what I mean?
You like being a good guy or a bad guy?
Well, I prefer being a good guy.
Well, that's the way you are in life.
Yeah, really, I prefer being a good guy.
Let's see you as a good guy in The Shining right now. Stay tuned for Stanley Kubrick's The Shining, based on Stephen King's novel, with Scatman Crothers. Thanks a whole lot.
Thank you, Mick.
Pleasure.
Good. Okay.